Good day, everyone. Time now for weather news with J7409, the name you know, the news that you can use. What's coming up today? Well, we have a risk of some severe weather today across parts of the southern New England, the southern mid-Atlantic coast, the central high plains, and the northern Great Basin into the northern Rockies. That's what's coming up. I'll tell you all about it in today's weather news. Starting off, we have, of course, a look at the jet stream for today. And if this is your first time over to weather news with J7409, please subscribe, click the bell, check off the email notification to make sure you get all the latest in weather news, forecasts, watches, warnings, and tropical weather. This GFS map, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. Thank you, Levi. I appreciate it very much for you let us using your graph that you keep up to date every 6 hours. We appreciate it a lot. Also, before I say anything else, let's all of us keep in our thoughts and prayers everyone in Hawaii as Lane gets closer to the islands today. Okay, other than the heavy rain and severe weather I was telling you about across the Ohio Valley and the Mid-Atlantic and right on over, also fire, weather, and air quality concerns is a big concern and continues for portions of the western U.S. Let's turn the map on, see what it's looking like, and it seems that the thunderstorms, along with embedded heavy rainfall, is spreading across portions of the Ohio Valley and Mid-Atlantic region today as a slow-moving frontal system moves to the east, and it is slow. Now, a large portion of the Ohio Valley, central Appalachians, and the Mid-Atlantic is going to continue to have favorable conditions for strong to severe thunderstorms through this morning, okay, through this morning to like lunchtime. Maybe after lunchtime we'll get a break. We'll have to wait and see. Now, within the same region, slow cell motion will favor high rainfall rates and increase the risk for some flash flooding, although not as high a risk as the favored area for the higher rainfall today. Now, it's going to be over parts of New England. New England, you're going to get the heavy rain today, and the system is expected to continue moving east and exit the East Coast by tomorrow. Meanwhile, behind the system, a large area of high pressure is going to set in across the eastern U.S., resulting in much drier weather to finish out the work week. So that's going to be a good thing. Now, much of the west will remain in the drier air mass, and it will be conducive for elevated fire dangers. Red flag warnings are in effect for some areas of Northeast California and Northeast Nevada. The Pacific Northwest and portions of the Intermountain West counties to have widespread poor air quality due to the smoke from the ongoing fires. Now, our air quality alerts are in effect for all of the Pacific Northwest, northern Idaho, and western Montana. Furthermore, fires burning in British Columbia, Canada, are transporting smoke southward into portions of Minnesota. Scattered to widespread convection will steadily increase over the next few days for the Great Basin and southern central Rocky areas as monsoonal moisture returns to the region, and individual storms will have the potential to produce heavy rain. The area of convections is expected to shift toward the southern plains as the week progresses towards the weekend. Now, some of these storms could produce some flash flooding, especially in the favorable terrain and urban areas, as well as across the burn scar regions. Flash flooding will also be a concern in the high plains, where above normal rainfall has already occurred over this past week. Checking out the Cape map really quick this morning, measuring the energy in the air to produce severe weather, such as the severe storms and waterspouts and tornadoes. That's the main concern when I look at the Cape readings, okay? This is around 10 a.m. this morning. We'll move up some to around 12 noon lunchtime today. We can see some has started to grow in North Carolina, Florida, down around the coastal sections of Texas, as we move on through to around 4 p.m. this afternoon. You see what it's looking like where it's red. That is the greater energy in the air. We will move up to around 10 p.m. this evening, all around the southern coast of North Carolina, the entire coast of South Carolina, and some of the coast of Texas and Louisiana. Florida has spots of high energy starting to build, and we will move up to midnight tonight, and you can see what it's looking like now. Looking at the air quality, this is measuring, of course, all of the CO concentration in the air, and yes, now you know why all of the air quality alerts are out. Look how bad it is over in these areas. This is around 11 a.m. this morning. We will move up to around 2 p.m. this afternoon, 5 p.m. this afternoon, 9 p.m. this evening. Starting to grow over in New Jersey area now. Dissipated a little in some of these sections, still pretty heavy up around Washington State and up in Canada, parts of Nevada and California. And we will go to midnight tonight. Now, this is measuring the CO concentration. Let's check out the SO2 mass right quick. Okay, this is the SO2 mass concentration in the air. You can see all of the darker brown, and where it really gets red, it's really, really bad. This is around lunchtime today. We will move up to around 4 p.m. this afternoon and around 8 p.m. this evening and up to midnight tonight. And ending up this morning, we have the NAM map forecast up here. This is what your forecast should actually be in time. This is set for 9 a.m. this morning. We will move up to around lunchtime today. We can see these storms are progressing off the coast and up in the New England area here. The rain is happening, where we do have one of those chances of some severe weather. Now we'll go to around 3 p.m. this afternoon, and we'll move it up to 6 p.m. this afternoon. Trying to give you a little play-by-play here. As we move up to 9 p.m. tonight, the system finally tries to get out of New England. Still some rain in New York, Pennsylvania, West Virginia, along the border lines of West Virginia and Virginia. North Carolina still got some, with the heavier rain trying to get offshore now for the most part. We will move up to 11 p.m. this evening, and around 2 a.m. in the morning, you can see the other system is coming through now out of the west, and we have rain, pockets of convection rain showers all throughout this area, with most of this system off of the coast by now. Thank you so much for watching. Please subscribe. Please, please subscribe. Click that bell. Check out the email notifications and join us here at Weather News with J7409. We'd love to have you with us if you're into the weather like all of us over here are. Please stay safe, everyone. Thank you for everything you do for me. I love each and every one of you. You are my family. With all they said and done, everybody stay safe. Have a great day, a blessed day, and peace, love, and kindness to each of you.